hungry when I came to Israel. Then I far, far did go that Elijah will come again someday. I have seen him, he is real, and I just can't help but feel how much closer his kingdom is today. Signs of the times are everywhere, and we in Israel can say without fear, keep your eyes upon Elijah King. Obey his voice, the kingdom now is near. Wars and strifes on every hand, and violence fills our land. Still some people doubt that he's not the one, but the word of God is true. He redeemed his chosen few. Don't lose hope, Elijah will see us through. Without fear, keep your eyes upon Elijah your King. Obey his voice, the kingdom now is here. Wars and strifes on every hand, and violence fills our land. Still some people doubt that he's not the one, but the word of God. He'll redeem his chosen few. Don't lose hope, Elijah will see us through. Signs of the times are everywhere, and we in Israel can say without fear, keep your eyes upon Elijah your King. Obey his voice, now is here.
Shalom, which simply means peace be unto you. It is indeed a great blessing that we can come to you again with the House of Israel Bible class. We want to say special thanks to all the people that have been listening to our program. We want to say a warm welcome to all the people that listens and learn something every week. Because the program brings great inspiration, especially to our people. The House of Israel Bible class is a class to resurrect the black race, and not only the black race, but every race. Because the wisdom that is being poured out is able to develop our minds. It is able to give us life and teach us how to operate in this society. I want to say special praise and honor to our leader. Most of you have known him as David Hill or the Rabbi Because this knowledge that he has brought to us has opened out our understanding. He's a teacher that is more concerned with the restoration of our minds, of our culture, of all the things that we have lost. We have lost everything. But there is a reason why we lost everything. The black race is a special people unto God. And he has chosen them apart from every other nation. You know, sometimes when we speak like this, someone will say it's racism. But we must first be concerned with ourselves. Because 400 years of slavery has destroyed the black man. But yet, after the 400 years of slavery, the black man was set up in the white man's church. And sing, wash me and make me white as snow. A person can only sing such a song because they're destroyed. Because that individual feels he's worth nothing in this society. But I'm telling you, it is different. The white man wants us to be like this. That he can teach us more of his ways. That he can keep our minds in the sky and tell us, lay not treasures up here on earth. That when we die, go to heaven. He says everything is waiting up there for us. And this is the kind of teaching that God has a problem with. Because, you know, just after he finished telling you that, And I want to say this in passing, that black people by nature is a church-going folks. And all your wealth taking it. Police building schools for the right, for the white race. He's building supermarkets that you yourself would have to go into and buy from him. He's making sure that you remain poor. Because he's telling you that money is not important. Let me tell you something. When you build in a society, money is important. If he's telling you, don't lay your treasures here on earth, wait for them in heaven. Why is he building everything for himself? Why is he elevating himself? Building everything that his race can go up. And when the rabbi come and he started teaching you and said, look, we must buy from our own. We must look after our own. They say, don't worry with Rabbi, he's racist. But if we don't look after our own, who's going to look us after? And you know, God has seen this thing. I said, I'm going to be of help. I'm going to help these people. And he said, look, I got a controversy. We want to read in the book of Hosea 4 and verse 1. Listen to what God said. He says, hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel. For the Lord had a controversy. You see, God got a problem with this kind of teaching. That the reverence will lie to you. You see, he always gotta pacify you. But Jesus is coming to rescue you. Jesus' time has already finished. We got somebody better than Jesus that is going to rescue us. But listen to what it says. Hear ye the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel. For the Lord had a controversy with the inhabitants of the land. Because there is no truth. He said, what they're teaching. What they want you to believe. Said it's not truth. Yes. No mercy. Oh, I tell you, there is really no mercy in the land. You see, we're the only race that when our children come from school, let me tell you, they would sit on the corners. And they would lie, and they would smoke a joint and listen to some music that don't bring any inspiration. But who can we run to? Who can we turn to? When we look at our women folks, our girls, the black society has the most school dropouts. You study it. Look at our daughters. They drop out of school, and they gotta start working for Mr. Chin. And he don't give them an office, a job in the office. But he let them mop the floor. You see, we've dropped so low because we have rejected our God. We've rejected the knowledge that He came to pour into us. Listen. He said there's no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God. You tell the average man to seek God. Every nigger. Every fool that comes singing a song. He becomes our idol. Our youths, they don't want to follow no pattern after the leaders that the Bible talks about. But they want to follow Vibes Cartel and Alkaline. They want to dress like them. You know what's responsible for that? Listen to what Hosea 4 and 6. Listen what it says. It says, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. It is sad that we are the first people upon this earth. Yet, we don't know how to do anything. Said my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Because they rejected knowledge. They want to be like what they see on the TV. They see these 50 cents and these Lil Wayne's with a big quank of money. And they sing about drugs and guns. And we feel that's the right way. And our youths start to pursue a career in that. And we're losing them. Listen to what God say. My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Not that there's not any knowledge. Listen why. Because you have rejected knowledge. the system becomes so against us. That even the teachers in the schools, let me tell you, they know that the average black child, you gotta beat them to learn something. You always gotta whip them. And you know what? They've decided that we're not going to beat them anymore. Because long ago, when you didn't do something right, and your mother whipped you, you understand that if I don't do so, she's going to whip me again. And they said, look, we're going to stop all the schools from beating. So our children, they're in a don't care situation. They said, if I don't do it, nobody's going to beat me. Nobody's going to do me anything. Give them a reason that they can reject knowledge. Listen what God said. Because thou hast rejected knowledge. Listen. I also. No. This is God speaking. He said, I'm going to reject thee. When you don't know anything, nobody even wants to hire you. But if you're concerned about knowledge, I tell you, somebody's going to be concerned about you. Said, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing that thou hast forgotten the laws of God. When a society has no laws, the people do anything. And the reason we fall so low we've rejected even the laws that God put in place to govern us. Now, what I want to show you is for us to get up and see God again. You see, there must be a way that we can rise up again. We can meet it up. And it's written here in the book of 2 Chronicles 7 and verse 14. 2 Chronicles 7 and verse 14. Listen to what it says. It says, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves. You know, when you talk about humility, it's a certain way that you carry yourself. It's a more respectable way of doing things. And you get it if you seek God. Listen. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray. We got to learn to communicate with God. When we get up in the mornings, the first thought must be God. Oh, I tell you how we need someone to help us. Yes, listen, and pray. And seek my face. Now, God is telling us these are the things that we need to do to get a closer walk with Him. Seek means to go in search, to find out who is God. Let me tell you, most of our people that have been in all of these religions, they don't know who's God. The youths came into the society seeing their mother with a white man hung up in the house. She told them, "This is your savior." And from since then, that is what we know. We don't do any research. Find out if God looked like us. But these are some of the things we gotta do if we're gonna take a closer walk with God. I wanna look at one more condition of the black race that God says He's gonna change. In the book of Jeremiah 30 and verse 17. Jeremiah 30 and verse 17. Because we of all people needs to be restored. And when we talk about restoration, we're talking about one person, only Elijah. When we talk about restore, we're talking about restoring the mind. Let me tell you something. Once the mind is not thinking right, you can safely say that person is crazy. The average black man, as soon as he has been paid on Friday, he's gone to fish shop. He's gone with his boys. And they would sit down drink 2 cases of beer. His mind is not on family life. Not thinking about his children. When he meets home, he gives to his wife whatever is left. And then during the week, he has to borrow a passage to meet to work. When he comes in, drunk, and he beat up his wife. Beat up his children. Because the mind is not thinking right. So the purpose of Elijah's coming. Listen to what he said I'm going to do for you. In the book of Jeremiah 13:17. Listen to what he said. He says, "For I will restore health, soundness in the mind." So I go restore your health unto thee. I go heal you. Oh, the black race needs to be healed. We fight each other. We kill each other. For the most simplest things. You look at the court system. See the prison population. It is blacks entirely. You know, even some of these songs, they preach violence. And that's what our youths sing the most. You know, I am not a lover of Vibes Cartel. But listen to what he sing. We want fast cash. Grab his stash. This is the kind of things that he tell our youths to do. You see, God really has to heal our mind. Said, "I'm going to heal thee of thy wounds," said the Lord. "Because they called thee an outcast." Says, "Because they called thee an outcast. Nobody wants us." I tell you, even in this country, that we're the second largest race. That the Chinese come from China. And when anything is wrong, they can go to the Chinese Association on breakdown. The Indians, they get somewhere to go. I tell you, even the Amerindians, they got somewhere to go. But we, this black man, he has nowhere to turn. God has looked at this thing. He has looked at the sufferings of these people. He has looked at how we toil night and day. And said that if these people would hear, I can heal them. Let's read one more. In the book of Revelation 21. And verse 3. I wanna say that there is hope. And our hope rests in Elijah. Listen what he said he's going to do. In the book of Revelation 21 and verse 3. Listen to what it says. And I heard a voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. It means that God has come down. That he can reach us. That he can talk to us. The Bible says, as a man speaketh to his friend, said, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself shall be with them. Listen to what he says. And God shall wipe away all tears. You know, we've been crying for the last 400 years. We've made a stage that we can't take it anymore. But this is the assurance that Elijah is giving us. Said, I'm going to wipe away all tears from your eyes. And there are going to be no more death. Elijah is telling us he's going to change this society. Sometimes we just dying to die. But the purpose of God's coming is that we can have life. That he can teach us how to live. I wanna leave this with you. What God is saying here that he's going to do for us. Listen what it says. It says he's going to wipe away no more death. There shall be no more sorrow, nor crying, nor pain, for the former things, they're passed away. Every Savior that comes to resurrect this black race, we have killed them. And Jesus is no different. Judas betrayed him for 30 pieces of silver. means that we as a nation, as a people, don't respect our leaders. We never seem to understand the vision that they have for us. We always think that their purpose is money. But I'm telling you, with a savior, with a person like Elijah, the wonderful things that he has done for the house of Israel and for every person that listens to him, he has brought great inspiration to our society. I'm trusting that you would continue to listen more and more of the House of Israel Bible class. And we can be of some inspiration to you, to your family, to your sons and your daughters.
Moses,
that they would choose the right path to walk in. This is what I want to leave with you. This time, until the next time, may the Lord Elijah bless and keep you.
Egypt land,
let my people